गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड डियर फ्रेंड्स, लास्ट प्रैक्टिकल आई डिस्कस द एसिड फास्टेनिंग सॉरी फॉर दैट इज सिंपल स्टेनिंग. इन टूडेज प्रैक्टिकल वी विल सी द नेक्स्ट एक्सपेरिमेंट और द नेक्स्ट प्रैक्टिकल दैट इज टू प्रिपेयर द न्यूट्रिएंट स्लांट और टू प्रिपेयर स्टेप फॉर सब कल्चरिंग ऑफ डिफरेंट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म एज टू प्रिपेयर द न्यूट्रिएंट स्लांट स्टेप फॉर सब कल्चरिंग ऑफ डिफरेंट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. So yes, what are the requirements for this practical? In that first cultures, in that there are requirement of two microorganism or sample of two organism, that is E. coli and Bacillus subtilis. Second apparatus for this experiment, conical flask, test tube, glass marking pencil, then burner, inoculating loop, then needle and petri plate. Yes, apparatus for this practical, conical flask, test tube, glass marking pencil, burner, inoculating loop, needle and petri plate. Next, that is equipments for this practical, hot air oven, pH meter, autoclave and balance. Yes, what are the requirements in that first culture? There is requirement of two sample, that is E. coli, that is Escherichia coli and Bacillus subtilis. Second, for apparatus, conical flask, test tube, glass marking pencil, burner, inoculating loop, needle and petri plate. Then equipments, hot air oven, there is requirement of hot air oven, pH meter, autoclave and balance. Next, we will see the principle of this practical. So, what is principle? It means what? The subculturing. What is subculturing? It is defined as the transfer of microorganism from. Yes, what is subculturing? It is defined as a transfer of microorganism from one medium to the another in a aseptic condition. Keep in mind, important that is, overall procedure is carried out under only aseptic condition. Yes, what is subculturing? It is only nothing but the transfer of microorganism from one medium to the another medium in a aseptic condition. It is used in microbiological testing. This subculturing is used in microbiological testing. Then it is also used to prepare or preserve the stock culture. Yes, what I am saying, this subculturing is used in microbiological test. And second, it is also used to prepare or preserve. It is also used to prepare or preserve the stock culture. Next, that is, what is inoculation? So this is all about subculturing. Next, that is inoculation. So what is inoculation? It is the artificial induction of microorganism into the culture medium. Yes, what is inoculation? It is the artificial induction of microorganism into the culture medium is known as inoculation. And this inoculation technique is important to promote the growth of microbes under the aseptic condition. Yes, this inoculation technique is important to promote the growth of microbes under the aseptic condition. Next, there is always possibility of contamination of unwanted microorganism during inoculation of the subculturing. Yes, what I am saying, there is always possibility of what? There is contamination of unwanted microorganism during the process of subculturing and the process of inoculation. The contamination may take place from, there is different sources of contamination, for example air, then laboratory surface, then benches and equipments. These are the some sources of contamination during the process of what? During the process of inoculation and subculturing. Therefore, this subculturing and the inoculation, it should be carried out. So the subculturing must be carried out in aseptic condition. The laminar airflow is device is used for aseptic handling. Yes, keep in mind, this laminar airflow is a device which is used for the aseptic handling. Next, that is the aseptic transfer of microorganism. It can be done in broth to slant, then slant to broth, then slant to agar plate, then agar plate to slant, then slant to agar stab and agar stab to agar plate for different experimental design. Yes, this aseptic transfer of microbes, it can be done in first broth to slant, then second slant to broth, then slant to agar plate, next agar plate to slant, then slant to agar Epsilon to agar step and next agar step to agar plate for their different experimental design, for their different experimental purpose. So this is all about what? The requirement and principle of this experiment. Next we will see the preparation of agar slant and step. This nutrient agar, the nutrient agar is a nutrient broth solidified by the addition of agar. This solid media is prepared by, or this solid media is prepared for what? Prepared for isolation of microbes by streak plate technique. This solid media is prepared by isolation of microbe by streak plate technique. Then preservation of culture or the study the colony characteristics of microbes. And then saffron agar is used for isolation of subculturing of fungi. Then saffron agar is used for what? Is used for isolation of the subculturing of fungi. Next we will see the composition of nutrient agar. Yes, first composition of this nutrient agar. First beef extract 10 gram, then peptone 10 gram, sodium chloride 5 gram, distilled water to make 1000 ml, then agar 20 gram, and pH that is 7.0. next we will see the composition of saffron agar. And that first glucose 20 gram, then peptone 10 gram, then distilled water to make 1000 ml, then agar 20 gram, and pH 5.4. keep in mind the difference between these two agar, nutrient agar and saffron agar. Next we will see the procedure for slant and step preparation. First, in that first step, weigh all ingredients accurately or as per required quantity and dissolve in water. Then second, yes, first what I am saying, weigh all the ingredients accurately and dissolve in water. Second, adjust the pH of media by the use of 1 normal HCl or the 1 normal NaOH. Second step, adjust the pH of media by the use of what? By using 1 normal HCl and 1 normal NaOH. Then this media is heated on the burner in order to dissolve the all ingredients till to get a clear yellow colored liquid. Yes, what is third step? The media is heated until what? Until to get a clear yellow colored liquid. Then pour the agar into conical flask and plug it with cotton swab. Next, that is pour the agar into conical flask and plug it with the cotton swab. Next, then the media is sterilized at a temperature 121 at 15 IBS pressure for 15 minutes. Then sterilized all the glassware during the same time. Then after sterilization, allow to cool at moderate temperature and transfer into a aseptic place. Then disinfect the working platform and flame the two burners. Then the culture media and glassware are placed into this aseptic area. Then the pour the sterilized media from conical flask into the test tube and hold the test tube in a vertical position. Yes, pour the sterilized media media from conical flask into the test tube and hold the test tube in a vertical position and allow to solidify to get agar step. Next, pour the sterilized media from conical flask to the test tube and hold the test tube in an inclined position and allow to solidify to get a agar slant. Yes, what is difference? First, the pour the sterilized media from what? The conical flask into the test tube and hold the test tube in a vertical position and allow to solidify to get a agar step. And second thing, that is pour the sterilized media from conical flask into the test tube and hold the test tube at an inclined position and allow it to solidify to get a agar slant. Then next, that is procedure for subculturing. First, that first step, label the test tube for subculture with name of microorganism and date. Then hold the test tube in your left hand and separate the test tube टू फॉर्म ए वी शेप. देन यूज द राइट हैंड फॉर हैंडलिंग द इनोक्युलेटिंग लूप. देन स्टेरिलाइज द इनोक्युलेटिंग लूप बाय होल्डिंग इन ए फ्लेम ऑफ बंसन बर्नर टिल इट गेट रेड हॉट. देन कूल द इनोक्युलेटिंग लूप. देन ओपन द प्लग ऑफ टेस्ट ट्यूब एंड फ्लेम द नेक ऑफ टेस्ट ट्यूब. यस, ओपन द प्लग ऑफ टेस्ट ट्यूब एंड फ्लेम द नेक ऑफ टेस्ट ट्यूब. देन इंसर्ट द इनोक्युलेटिंग लूप इन टू द स्टॉक कल्चर एंड पिकअप द स्मॉल नंबर ऑफ माइक्रोब्स. देन आफ्टर दैट दिस लूप इज इंसर्टेड इन टू द लेबल्ड सब कल्चर टेस्ट ट्यूब. देन इन केस ऑफ ब्रॉथ कल्चर ट्यूब द लूप इज डीप इन टू द कल्चर एंड जेंटली शेकन टू डिसलॉज द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. नेक्स्ट, इन केस ऑफ अगार स्लांट ट्यूब द लूप इज स्लाइटली ड्रॉन ऑन सॉलिडिफाइड सर्फेस ऑफ अगार इन ए जिगजैग फैशन. नेक्स्ट, इन केस ऑफ अगार स्टैप लूप इज इंसर्टेड इन ए स्ट्रेट लाइन इन बॉटम ऑफ अगार ट्यूब एंड विड्रॉन अलोंग द लाइन ऑफ इंसर्शन. नेक्स्ट, फ्लेम द नेक ऑफ टेस्ट ट्यूब. देन अप्लाई द प्लग. देन अप्लाई प्लग टू द टेस्ट ट्यूब. एंड लास्ट, दैट इज इनक्यूबेट ऑल द टेस्ट ट्यूब्स एट 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस फॉर 24 आवर्स. यस, लास्ट दैट इज आफ्टर ऑल द प्रोसीजर और आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस प्रोसीजर इनक्यूबेट द ऑल टेस्ट ट्यूब्स एट 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस फॉर 24 to 48 आवर्स. ने आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस आवर्स व्हाट इज ऑब्जर्वेशन ऑफ रिजल्ट. द ग्रोथ ऑफ माइक्रोब्स कैन बी ऑब्जर्व इन द फॉर्म ऑफ टर्बिडिटी. यस, हियर वी कैन ऑब्जर्व द टर्बिडिटी आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ इंक्यूबेशन. द ग्रोथ ऑफ माइक्रोब्स कैन बी ऑब्जर्व इन द फॉर्म ऑफ व्हाट? इन द फॉर्म ऑफ टर्बिडिटी इन ए ब्रॉथ कल्चर ऑफ अपीयरेंस ऑफ डिफरेंट कलर्ड ग्रोथ इन ए स्लांट ऑफ द अगार डीप. So this is all about the composition of this media, that is nutrient, then preparation of slant, then preparation of stap and the subculturing of different microorganism and the preparing of subculturing of different microorganisms. Yes, first question for this experiment, what is inoculation? Yes, what is inoculation? It is the artificial induction of microorganism into the culture medium is called as inoculation. Then second, what is mean by subculturing? Yes, as I already discussed, what is subculturing? Subculturing is defined as what? The transfer of microorganism from one medium to the another medium in a aseptic condition, that is nothing but subculturing. Then next, what is agar slant? Agar prepared in test tube to get inclined solidified surface for growth of microbes is called as slant. Then what is incineration? Yes, it is the process of sterilization of inoculating loop in flame of Bunsen burner till it is red hot. Yes, what is incineration? It is the process of what? It is the process of sterilization of inoculating loop in flame of Bunsen burner till red hot. And last question, which culture media has liquid consistency? Yes, the nutrient broth is a culture media which having a liquid consistency. Which culture media having the liquid consistency? Yes, the nutrient broth is a culture media which having a liquid consistency. These are the questions for this experiment. First, what is inoculation? Then what is meant by subculturing? Then what is agar slant? Then what is incineration? And last, that is which culture media has a liquid consistency. So this is all about this experiment, that is for preparing the nutrient slant, that is for preparing a nutrient slant, then stab and for subculturing of different microorganisms. I will stop here. Next experiment we will see in next practical.